Hello and welcome to part one of UC on UCS C-Series P2V migration video. My name is Paul Stryer, an architecture consulting engineer for Cisco Systems. The goal of this lab is to set up a UCS C-Series server, install ESXi, and migrate a physical Cisco Unified Communications Manager server to a virtual machine. Along the way, you will get the opportunity to set up the RAID array on the C-Series server, as well as set up an EtherChannel from the attached Cisco switch to the two data NICs on the C-Series server. In this first video, we will explore the first three sections of the lab agenda. In the first section, we will baseline the existing voice network by making phone calls between two soft phones. In the second part, we will prepare for a P2V migration by backing up the Cisco Unified Communications Manager's database. And in the third section, we will use the Cisco Integrated Management Console to configure the RAID array controller. Baselining the existing voice network. In this section, we will test the existing voice network by making a phone call between the two phones. From phone 1 on the left, I will make a phone call to the phone on the right. As you can see, I have made a successful phone call, proving that the existing VoIP network is working. In this section, we will perform a DRS backup to prepare for a physical to virtual migration of the CUCM server. To begin the backup, open Internet Explorer and navigate to your Cisco Unified Communications Manager. Accept the self-signed security certificate, click Continue to website. From the navigation drop-down window, select Disaster Recovery System and click Go. Enter your username and password and select Login. Select Backup and Manual Backup. Select your device name, which has already been created for you. Select Car and UCM and click Start Backup. Click OK to accept the warning. For the sake of time, I will fast forward to the end of the backup. Now that the backup has finished successfully, you can check the files by going to the SFTP server, click on PuTTY, then click on NTP, and click Open. Click Yes on the security alert. Enter your username, enter your password, enter the command ls to list the files. The ones in red are the backup files. To ensure there are no communications problems with duplicate IP addresses, we are going to shut down the Cisco Unified Communications Manager. From the CLI, type utils system shutdown, hit enter. Type in yes to confirm, and click enter again. In this section, we will review the Cisco Integrated Management Console that has been pre-configured with an IP address. We will also configure the RAID array controller to use two hard drives for our OS partition and three hard drives for our UC partition. Open Internet Explorer. Enter in your C-Series server's network management IP address or hostname. Accept the self-signed certificate by clicking Continue to this website. Enter the default username of admin with the password of password. Since this C210 is currently powered on, we will click Power Off Server to power the server off. Click OK to confirm the power off. To view the console, we can click Launch KVM Console. Click Yes when prompted to trust the website certificate. Click Run on the digital signature. Now going back to the CIMC console, click Power On Server. Click OK to confirm the power on. The server boot process can be monitored by returning to the KVM console. The next thing we'll do is configure the hard drives by configuring the array controller. We will get into the MegaRAID BIOS configuration utility by pressing Control H during the boot process. For the sake of time, I will fast forward to the end of the boot process. When you see the list of hard drives, hit Control H. Press Start to enter the RAID array application. Click Configuration Wizard. Click New Configuration and click Next. Click Yes to confirm. Select Automatic Configuration and Redundancy when possible and click Next. Preview hard disk configuration and click Accept. Click Yes to save the configuration. Here we are going to select the boot drive. Click the smaller of the two drives. Select Set Boot Drive and click Go. Click the Home key to go back to the main menu and select Exit. Click Yes to exit the application. Then from Macros, select Control-Alt-Delete to reboot the box. Thank you for watching this video. Please continue on to part 2 to see the VMware ESXi install.